just as scientists began drawing up research plans, a new threat emerged. Fishers began catching sixgills from the piers around Seattle.
I had heard as part of my weekly fishing report that there is an angler down on the Seacrest Pier in West Seattle, right down Seattle, basically, that had learned how to catch sixgill sharks, big ones, you know. I mean, we knew, and they were out there. They were kind of this mysterious creature that no one ever caught or really encountered. So when he started catching them, it was like, wow, that's interesting. We wrote a very short story saying this guy was catching sharks off the Seacrest Pier.
This is the first time sixgill sharks really came to almost everybody's public attention here in the Northwest.
The next morning, I returned to work, and my email inbox was loaded with kind of nasty emails from divers. It turns out scuba divers had been swimming with these sharks, and they were upset that this guy was catching and killing these sharks.
He was very successful at catching a number of sharks in a very short period of time. And at the very same time, shark sightings at that dive site dropped off to zero.
Very little, as it turns out, was known about the population of sixgill sharks in Puget Sound, and they were worried that it might lead to an over-harvest situation or might harm the population. And they were angry at me for publicizing it.
At the time, it was perfectly legal. There was no fisheries protections or regulations on the sixgill shark at all in place. It was pretty much open season on them.
Scientists worried the sharks would be fished out before they had a chance to study them. And divers feared fishing would wipe them out completely. On the waterfront, relations between divers and fishers grew hostile.
It was pretty tense. There was a lot of name calling, and it was very confrontational.
When the fishing occurred, we drafted a letter to the Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife asking for a closure to the fishery on sixgill sharks.
The dive community just came out in full force, and hundreds, if not thousands of people called and said, hey, you need to close this fishery, this isn't right.
In the summer of 2000, state officials suspended all sixgill fishing in Puget Sound. With protections in place, the aquarium could begin its research. But answering even the simplest questions would prove difficult. For starters, scientists would have to find this large, free-ranging shark in a water body the size of Rhode Island. Where do you begin the search in an area that big?